Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel. I hope you all alright and having a good day. We are here today to do another episode of PlayStation VR 2 show. My weekly show in which we talk in everything PlayStation VR 2, all the news, all the latest information. A very good video today. We've got two games confirmed for PlayStation VR 2, but also the Boneworks developer had a look on the new controllers and got some great news for PlayStation VR owners. Plus, Sony investing heavily in virtual reality and augmented reality, so maybe let's get started. First part of the show is the news. So of course the biggest news last week was the reveal of those new controllers. I already done a few videos about it, so I don't want to spend too long talking about them now, but basically Sony showed them, they look beautiful, and they confirmed that they're gonna be supporting inside-out tracking, they're gonna have those awesome haptics that Sony developed for DualSense, but also adaptive triggers, the Halo Ring looks very nice, the design themselves is just work of art, thumbsticks is here, so I think that was the most requested feature for new controllers, and also they support finger touch detection, so very very nice controllers. But after that we've got some more information from the developers. So first of all, Lo-Fi developer said yes, this game, the Lo-Fi, will be coming to PlayStation VR 2. We already knew that he's gonna release it on PlayStation 5, but when he said PlayStation 5, that is the flat version. Now what we know is that eventually when PSVR 2 releases, the Lo-Fi will support PlayStation VR 2. So this is very nice. The developer don't want to call it cyberpunk game. Neo-Noir, as he described it, Neo-Noir adventure set in the future looks very nice. I really like what I'm seeing. Still working hard on it. I don't know how long till the release date, but what I'm seeing is a very, very good thing. And another developer spoke about their game and support for PlayStation VR. So the studio that gonna bring us Synth Riders, and they say in PSVR 1 and PS4 and PS5, we'll get this game this year, but also after the release of PSVR 2, they gonna do the PSVR 2 version, so I don't know how much they will be able to upgrade, but probably definitely resolution. And also it must be first VR rhythmic game on PSVR 2 that will support those amazing haptics. So pretty much you'll be able to hear the music with the palms of your hands. Very nice, Synth Rider, very popular game on the PC VR. Many people playing it and enjoy the original gameplay. So yeah, I'll be looking forward to play it on PSVR 1, but definitely to try it on PlayStation VR 2. And now moving on to the Boneworks, a very, very requested game for PlayStation VR. Now PSVR version is out of questions. They can't do it. I already mentioned it in past. Basically, what's been happening is maybe even if PS4 original had enough power to pull off the Boneworks, sadly the controllers didn't have enough of anything to actually run Boneworks. So what the developer need is good tracking, thumbsticks, good button placement, and Move controllers just been lacking all of it, so they couldn't port it. But after Sony announced PlayStation VR 2 controllers, the developer of Boneworks commented and said that they didn't show the real things yet, but by judging by the picture, just by looking at them, they are 90% sure that they will be able to port Boneworks to PlayStation VR 2. So looks like things are finally starting to happen. Of course PSVR 2 won't come out this year, but nevertheless nice to see the Boneworks developer is looking into it, especially that judging just by the pictures of new controllers, they 90% sure. So I'm kind of convinced once they gonna get real thing in their hands and they be able to use PS5 power, they be able to easily port Boneworks to PlayStation VR 2, so that's very, very good news. And another bit of news is Sony proving that they still investing in virtual reality, but also augmented reality as well, so they lately joined VR and AR Association. And what is this association? Basically, it's many companies coming together in order to push this technology forward. So, as you can see, Sony is very heavily invested. Now, PSVR 2 gonna be a new format, they saying. Who knows, maybe it's gonna have some AR capabilities, but also Sony works on this spatial display, which is pretty awesome, this light field display with eye tracking. So to describe it easiest, imagine like you're looking at things in VR and they look so real, that's what's happening on their latest screen. So you're gonna look at it, it's gonna be like VR on the screen, but without headset. Very, very nice technology. I wonder if Sony ever gonna implement it in gaming, but nevertheless, that proves that how much they care about VR and AR. And Sony being the biggest electronics manufacturer, one of the biggest ones, that's just good sign how good this doing. And also with latest comments from Facebook saying that trajectory is only up and we can expect more AAA and big games and use of VR in many parts of different industries, it looks like this technology is just on the verge of becoming proper mainstream. How many years that's gonna be, I don't know, but definitely VR growing nice and many companies coming together to push it even more forward. Awesome. Now, let's move on to the next part of the show, which is wishlist. And today we're gonna talk about Half-Life Alyx. So in this part of the show, I like to talk about the games that maybe are not confirmed for PSVR 2, but there is possibility to get them once PSVR 2 releases. I chose Half-Life Alyx this week because in past the developers said that they want to as many people as possible to play this game and they never excluded ports to different software. Now, with PlayStation VR 2 or whatever Sony is going to call it just around the corner, this might just happen and Valve might port Half-Life Alyx. Like I said, they never excluded any ports, but they want to give it to more players and PSVR 2 would seem an obvious choice. Half-Life Alyx still one of the best VR games, but just like with the Boneworks, even if they wanted to do it now on PS4 original, even if somehow they would manage to squeeze all the bits of power of it and run this game on PS4 with PSVR 1, sadly, just like with Boneworks, the controllers are not up to scratch. That's why the Half-Life Alyx on PSVR 1 probably will never happen. Move controllers with its lack of thumbsticks, with its limited tracking, and not enough buttons, or maybe even if it's enough, they in totally wrong place. Sadly, moves are not up to it, but PSVR 2 controllers kind of following industry's standard now. They probably gonna be much, much easier for the developers to work with, and it would be super awesome if Valve had a look at them, just like Boneworks developer, and said, okay, yeah, now it's possible. And especially with PS5 powering PSVR 2, I'm sure just like with Boneworks, for the Half-Life Alyx developers, it would be easy to port this game. So yeah, that was my wishlist this week. I hope it's gonna happen, my wishlist game. Will it though? I don't know, but like I said, in this part of the show, I just like to include the games that possibly might happen. Okay, and moving on to another part of the show, this is Burning Questions, which we try to wonder about things that PSVR 2 might or might not do. And this question was asked by one of viewers on this channel, Ghastly B, and he says he wants to know if PSVR 2, if Sony gonna let us use 3D Blu-rays on this new headset. Now, as we know, on PS5 3D support, I don't think it's working. On PS4 it's been working, but of course, even though it looks alright, it's kind of limited due to the PSVR 1's resolution. So on PSVR 2, if they gone for higher resolution, I mean 4K would be awesome. Supporting the Blu-rays with the 3D, that would be just no-brainer, because it doesn't seem like it's hard feature to implement if they did it in PSVR 1. So with higher resolution, which gonna turn to better media playback, I would think Sony probably would do it. Of course, this is the question we need to have answers for. As of now, we don't know much, but let me know what you think and let me know if you got any questions for PSVR 2. And also, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.